everybody. Rich with Mustang Connection. Thank you so much for stopping by. Thanks for viewing all year. Our channel in 2017 saw some nice growth. We had lots of new viewers, lots of new comments. Subscriptions, like I said, are up. Views are up. Likes are up. So thank you to everyone who subscribed and watched in 2017. And for those brave enough to leave comments down below, it's always appreciated. And wishing everyone out there a very happy
comments
new year.
Comments down below.
What was your favorite video, your favorite car of 2017 on Mustang Connection? And maybe what your New Year's resolutions are for your hobbies, whatever that might be. Thank you so much again, everyone. Have a happy, healthy, prosperous 2018. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see y'all soon.
Hey, this is Mike.
I'm Jim.
Go ahead. We're watching a Mustang Connection.
Let's try that again.
You've never done this.
Go ahead. This is Mike with the Ringbrothers.
And I'm Jim, and thanks guys for watching the Mustang Connection.
Hey everybody, what's Mustang Connection? I am with Jim and Mike Ring, the famous Ringbrothers. At SEMA 2017. Thanks guys for taking the time, as always, really appreciate it. So, we're gonna walk around this latest build. You wanna talk about it a little bit?
Yeah. Behind us, a 56 Ford F-100 cab, sitting on a 54 frame and front clip. Pretty much didn't use a whole lot of anything. We built the box here from scratch, tailgate, cleaned up the cab, grip grills. The truck's actually wider by, what, 4 inches?
Yeah, we widened the fenders in the rear and tightened them up. Sean got a shop, built the whole box from scratch and the tailgate. And, yeah, we tightened up the fenders. Not only did we widen them, we actually tightened them up and actually gave a little motion look to the rear fenders. And then the front end was the same thing. We moved the suspension 7 inches forward of where it was originally. We took all that meat that's in the front of the fender and moved it to the back of the fender and shortened that opening too and gave it a little motion there also.
So in classic style, you know this is a 56 truck,
right?
But that really ends there. It's completely custom.
Taillights, took some brackets, made the brackets, took an old, I think it's like a 37 aftermarket, actually a taillight that we adapted to our brackets that we made.
And then the lip too is so neat on the bed.
Yeah, and there's no latch on the bed, so this thing doesn't have a latch. So what we did is put super heavy springs in it. But it comes down.
Wow, it's real light.
It goes over center. When we milled out, when we made the things, milled it out for it backwards.
This is all custom made.
Yeah.
What's this made out of?
This is steel and aluminum.
Is it really? Wow. So that's not hard. Look at that. And then it has this really cool lip that kind of almost doubles as a spoiler. Yeah, so cool.
It still looks kind of old school and follows it around.
Well, let's do it with the bed. It's beautiful.
That is cherry that we built some rails, and it's actually a tongue and groove, like you just set inside and we left a quarter inch gap in there. It's just something, it was one of Jim's ideas to just make it look a little more functional. I guess you can haul rock and different size grit by the end.
It's really neat.
The running boards we made, they originally don't go all the way forward. And we put like a toe around, you can't hardly see it here, but it rounds in for your feet. But this part here is actually machined aluminum, but we powder coated to make it look rubber.
Yeah, it's really, so that's going to be super durable.
Yeah, so it looks like a rubber insert.
Now, are these wider?
Yes.
They are.
So they're made from scratch.
They are, and as where is the rear fender is?
Is wider also, and then tightened up. The doors are all rounded. Normally they have square corners. The drip rails removed, but yeah, we added the lip
kind of style line to it. Yeah, really neat.
Smooth it. Because these kind of nice about the 56 is they've got their own visor built in them. They're kind of cool.
Yeah, it's talking about, you can see there. So really, the stockest part's probably just the roof. That's it.
And they originally had these, a lot of guys get rid of them, you know, for the old fence, but we actually put them in on the other side too, because we kind of like the look of it, so we added one to the other side. Normally they're only on the right side.
Plus it almost gives it a kind of a nod to the louvers of the old school days, right?
Exactly, and then again the wheels being moved ahead. We did not chop the hood or anything. It just, with this massive 54 grill, we felt like, don't mess with the hood. You know, it just didn't need it. really fell in love with the 54 grill.
And, so that's a 54 grill in there.
54 grill. The bumper is a 58 Ford rear rear bumper from 58 Ford. We flipped it upside down and bent it, and kind of added some edges to it. And then advanced plating, re-chromed the whole thing.
It's stunning.
Underneath, it's just a crate Coyote, and if anybody knows these, they just run so good. And it's just a great run.
It's a bulletproof, modern, you know, modern miracle, really, whatever.
And I know a lot of guys know the Crown Vic swaps work good. The only thing we did is narrow it up 5 inches.
Oh, so this is a modified Crown Vic Panther platform?
Yep, and it really worked good on this. It's got a RideTech 4-link in the rear. It's got all those shocks in it.
And these are one-off HREs. And
they're not one-offs. It's
really?
It's one on the wheel, but Jim picked them. Everybody was like, oh, that's our new wheel. But actually, after he did it, people are liking it. The inside is pretty cool. We tried to retain the old school look. Even with the column, we left it. We used the original three in the tree, but converted it to the automatic.
Yeah.
Just to keep it more old school. The seats was the original bench that Steve at Upholstery Unlimited redid. And even this insert is to mimic the outside door.
And this is a modern fabric, but it has an old school feel to it. Yeah.
Even the headliner looks like an old Zoot suit, you know, it kind of...
It's really cool. It's kind of a light olive pinstripe, dual olive pinstripe inside a camel colored kind of, or a light colored thing. What color? This is actually a tinted... It's actually a little green in it, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does have green in it. You got a good eye. I don't know if it'll show up in this, but yeah, we added green because it kind of pulls together with the fabric that we use.
Yeah, a lot of the taupes and stuff that really feed well off of the olive, the olive color of the cab and stuff. And then what's neat is what they've done is they've carried the interior color in here. You can see that. That's not body color, so it's a really nice contrast down just, you know, it ends at the rocker, but it's really neat. Oops. It's really neat. I just dropped my plastic glasses on there.
So the door panels, you know, just to, you know, these are actually the original 54, 56 armrests, but we made caps for them, our door handles, because the aftermarket we found wouldn't work very well, so we had to make some. Original door handles, mirrors. Again, this custom cab is what we actually used for the seat to give it, you know, put something
to kind of mirror image it, yeah.
Yeah. So.
And how much wider is the step side on this, Mike?
So it would be 4 inches wider.
Is it really? Wow. So does that mean that the rear fenders are also 4 inches wider?
Two per side.
Two per side, okay. And then these are massive back here. What size are these things?
No, I'd be lying to you because we changed tire because we felt like, I guess we have a little Bobby Alley influence here with the big tire on the rear. You know, I honestly don't even know.
It's huge, how about that? Yeah.
Yeah, it's a big tire. It's a Nitto. They're 20s, but they're a big 20.
What, so this, is this on any type of air ride or no?
No, this is air ride height, all on coilovers.
It's stunning. Mike and Jim do the best work, everybody knows that. It's how, I mean, just it's they do the best work. Yeah. They have three builds here, I mentioned that. I'm going to try and get over and check out their Javelin too. But this F-100 is unbelievable. Mike, you guys knocked it out of the park again.
Thanks a lot, appreciate it.
And really appreciate the time, as always. I know they're really busy guys here at SEMA. And, anyway.
Thanks,
Mike. Appreciate it. Take care.